Coming up on today's show.
I was sitting at home waiting to either have a disabling stroke or maybe have a stroke that would kill me. And all of a sudden, it's all gone. It's never come back.
All of that and more on today's show.
Steve Millar, and I'm one of the ministers at Grace Cathedral, and this is my lovely wife, Kathy. On today's program, we have two special guests that are going to share their wonderful miracles that God performed in their lives.
But we're going to start with our first guest, Carissa. Welcome to the program.
Thank you.
How are you today?
I'm good. I'm excited to be here.
Well, we're very excited to have you here. And you're one of our newer members of Grace Cathedral. How long have you been with us now?
I came to Grace Cathedral in just between 2015 and 2016. I'd been in a lot of other churches and denominations as I grew up. And so when I first came here, it wasn't like anything I had ever experienced before.
Have you ever been in a Pentecostal church?
Or? I had never been in a Pentecostal church. And I was like, wow, okay. And I had had a lot of different experiences. I had been looking for the Lord my whole life. But when I came here, as soon as I came in the door, I could feel something. And at the time, I didn't understand. Now I know that it's the presence of the Lord. But when I first came in, it felt wonderful. I had this peace the whole time I was here. But it was very different than what I was used to. But it was exciting, too, because there were things I had always read about, you know, when I would be reading my Bible growing up, and I never saw them. I never even heard about them being preached, and I would see them in my Bible, and I would think, well, where is that? Where is that? Why did that stop? And I actually, for a long time, thought that there was a verse in the Bible somewhere that I had just never found that said, there won't be any more healings, there won't be any more miracles, there won't be any more Holy Ghost. None of these things will ever happen again until the end. And so when I came here, I was hearing and seeing all of these things that I had always wondered, where is this? Where right. is this?
So your Bible was coming alive right before
yes.
your very eyes.
Yeah. And, you know, some things were hard for me. I'm a nurse. And so some things like miracles and healings at first, I had trouble with because I thought, well, okay. But over time, the Lord was able to work on me as I saw and heard more testimonies. We had a wonderful revival about 6 months after I came here, and people that I knew, people that I saw every week, were giving testimonies that I knew were not medically possible. And they had medical evidence. They had test results and EKGs. They had CAT scans and x-rays. And one lady had been in a clinical trial, and they had to throw her out of it because she no longer had her illness. And as I was sitting there listening to all of these testimonies, I thought, well, that's for real. Well, that's for
so
real.
So you were kind of skeptical at first.
I was. And then the Lord did something beautiful for me, which is once he showed me, hey, wake mm-hmm. up, this is real. Then when I went up on the platform, and said the sinner's prayer with Reverend Angeli. I also got a beautiful miracle of my own at the same time. And so I was able to not only see and hear from others, hey, miracles are real. Mm-hmm. The Holy Ghost is real. These things are real. But I was able to experience that for myself. And as a medical science-based person, several things also had stuck out to me right from the beginning. Reverend would say all the time, you know, we love our good doctors and nurses and our medical people, but the Lord is the healer ultimately. Mm-hmm. And as I know from the different specialties I've had, you can have a patient have the same surgery as somebody else, and one will heal and one will recover and one may not. And so that made sense to me. Well, of course, the Lord mm-hmm. is the healer,
right.
no matter what mm-hmm. You have done. And then something else that he kept saying that really stuck out to me, especially because of where I was coming from spiritually, was everything he said. He would say, don't take my word for it, check in your Bible. And so I would go home even before I had realized, hey, miracles are real, this is real. I would go home and I would look in my Bible and everything I heard would be in there. And I would think, oh, well, that is in there. I didn't realize that. And so everything that I heard and saw was verified in the Word of God. And that made a huge difference for me also.
Right. And the Holy Spirit was schooling you.
Mm-hmm.
He was taking you to the Word and backing it up, what you were seeing. And I think that's wonderful that the Holy Spirit was able to do that for you.
And I've seen people in the past where, you know, maybe they come from have a different religious background like you did, and they're just not used to being in a Pentecostal church. On top of that, you know, you have to realize that you're a doctor, you know, I mean, you're a nurse, and, you know, having that medical background, you know, that sometimes it doesn't match up with science.
Mm-hmm.
So you had two things against you, but you were a believer. And
yeah.
you trusted in God.
I was hard, skeptical, so many things. And the Lord just broke through all of that.
So each time you saw a miracle, you were kind of just, you weren't sure if it was 100% God or, you know, it was just kind of hard to
It was
accept.
Hard for me to accept. And then when I saw people that I knew, people that I saw here mm-hmm. every week when I came to service, giving testimonies for things that happened that have lasted 5, 10, 20, mm-hmm. 40 years. And they've got medical evidence that I understand mm-hmm. and that made sense to me. And I would think, well, that's not possible. The EKG, you know, if you have a heart attack, even after you recover, you can see that there was damage. It'll say, actually, on the report, old infarct, old heart attack.
Mm-hmm.
People that had perfect EKGs that had other ones that showed they did have a heart attack.
Mm-hmm.
Or they would talk about how they had labs showing they had a heart attack, and they all of a sudden the labs disappear and they're all normal, and they go to the heart cath lab and there's nothing there. And so I was, my nurse mind was like, hey, that's not possible.
This is a miracle.
And then the Lord was so good to me. I had a pretty severe neurological condition that runs in my family. And for most people, it never got as severe as it was for me. And that's complex pattern migraines with auras. And I had neurological symptoms. Other people in my family had other types of issues, but mine were much more severe. And when I was a teenager, it was every couple months. And then in my 20s, it was every couple weeks. And by the time I came and I was here at Grace Cathedral, it was almost every day. And then they never went away. And my neurologist, who I had seen for quite some time, when I reported at an appointment that my last set of symptoms had never gone away, I would have numbness and tingling, almost like you took chalk and drew a line down the middle of my face, of my whole body, my arm, my leg, everything would be numb, tingling, maybe not move so well,
mm-hmm.
and my mind would feel fuzzy, and sometimes my speech would be a little slow. I'm a nurse, I know what those things mean. And they can be with the migraine issues that I had, but they're also pretty significant signs of stroke. And the last time I saw my neurologist, he said, you know, these haven't gone away. It's been a month. You've probably actually had a stroke. And that's what I was always afraid of. In these migraines, your blood vessels get real small. They clamp down. And so something really little, like even a tiny clot that would normally not mm-hmm. be a problem, can cause really severe problems. And I knew that that was a risk and that they couldn't do anything to stop it. And I was unsaved at the time and I was living in fear. The symptoms were getting worse. I started to have mini seizures, although I didn't realize it until I discussed what I was experiencing with my grandfather, who's a physician. And he said, Carissa, you know better. That's a seizure. And I thought, oh, it is. And so I was scared. and I didn't know what to do. I knew that my neurologist really couldn't help me. The CAT scans and the MRIs, you know, they tell you what's going on, they don't fix mm-hmm. it. Mm-hmm. But when I went and I said the sinner's prayer and I got salvation, from that day in 2016 until now, I have never had another one. And I was sitting at home waiting to either have a disabling stroke or maybe have a stroke that would kill me. And all of the sudden, it's all gone. It's never come back. And that was a great gift that the Lord gave me to, you know, see, you saw a miracle, you can get a miracle, and to free me from that fear, which
yes, that's
was wonderful.
Bondage.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
At the time that you said the sinner's prayer, you didn't even realize that you had received your miracle at that moment.
I did not. And in fact, I was so hard, and so bitter and just seared from the world that I became this new person. And it was like nothing I had ever experienced. My kids had to get used to me. It was like they didn't know who I was. And I could understand that because I didn't know who I was. I was laughing and smiling and acting not like I ever had before. And so I was so busy getting used to myself because I didn't even know who I was all of the sudden that it took me a little while to realize, hey, wait a minute, I don't have all of these things anymore. And when I did, I went back and I looked and I thought about it and I talked about it with my kids, with my mom. And I realized that the night that I got saved was the night that my symptoms stopped and never came back.
So you had a true born again experience.
I did.
You became brand new and the Lord gave you a miracle at the same time, not only for your soul, but for your body. And I think that's wonderful.
It was amazing. It was. And I got the Holy Ghost the same night. And for someone who before hadn't realized that you could even get the baptism of the Holy Ghost in this day, that was really spectacular. And it's so important. I always had read my Bible before, but I never, you know, I didn't have the Holy Ghost inside to open my understanding of what I was reading. And so for 30 years, I was reading my Bible, but the Lord couldn't really open it to my mm-hmm. understanding. And so I got the Holy Ghost and all of a sudden the Lord's bringing understanding
reality.
And
yes.
reality.
Yes.
And I've had a lot of trials and tribulations I've gone through. And I can honestly say that I don't know how I would have gotten through those without the Holy Ghost. He's your best friend. Mm-hmm. He's with you. He comforts you and teaches you. And so it was so special to me that I got the Holy Ghost the same evening with some of our good altar workers right after I got saved.
Now, you also received a miracle.
A notable miracle.
A notable miracle
that you
about your foot.
I did. I, in the fall, finished my first medium length fast. I fasted for just about 3 weeks. And when I came off that miracle fast, there were several miracles I hadn't been able to get. And one of them was that I had crippling plantar warts all over my right foot. I had had them for probably about 10 years. They had just gotten worse. I had tried burning them off with acid, freezing them off. I had seen a podiatrist. He could not get rid of them. We had painted them with formaldehyde. I tried to pick them out, peel them off, and they were simply spreading all over my foot.
Were there, how many do you think there were?
It was hard to tell because some of them were grouped together,
okay.
But my best guess is between 27 and 30.
Wow.
The biggest one was probably about that big around, maybe about the size of a 50-cent piece. It was huge.
So it was hard to even walk on that foot.
It was very sore. It hurt. I couldn't wear flip-flops, for example, because some of them were even creeping up between my toes.
Oh.
They were all over my toes, the sole of my foot, the ball of my foot. And I had tried to treat them medically, couldn't do it. And I said to the Lord after that fast, you know, I'm really sold out to you now, and I'm really following hard after, you know, the high calling. So let's go ahead and do this now. And so I read Healing from Heaven, which is a great book that we have that I had never actually read before.
Mm-hmm.
And I took a blessed cloth that our ministers pray over and used it kind of as a touch point for my faith. And I went ahead and I prayed and I committed it to the Lord. And I kind of just tried to forget that they were even there. Like, okay, I gave it to the Lord. I'm not even going to think about them anymore. And then I, about 2 weeks later, looked down at my foot, and some of them on my toe were completely gone. And I was like, where did those go? For a minute, I thought I was seeing things. I looked at my foot real close. I was like, oh, they're actually gone. And it was like they had never been there. Mm-hmm. And when I looked closer, the other ones, even the huge one, they weren't the same. They were smaller. They were turning black. And a very large, painful one, I tapped with my finger, and it actually crumbled into little pieces and fell off in my hand. And I was like, oh, wow. And it was maybe just 2 short weeks later, I would say, my foot was completely normal, like there had never been anything on it. And I had really pulled on the Lord for that because I could not continue like that. It hurt, it interfered with my walking, and I was so grateful that the Lord did that for me, because no matter how long and hard we had tried, we couldn't get rid of them medically, and so only the Lord was able to do that for me.
That's a wonderful miracle. That's just incredible. Well, we want to thank you so much, Carissa, for being on the show today.
Thank you.
And sharing your miracles with us. And now you're a believer that miracles are real.
I am, and I've had many.
Well, thank you again for being with us. And you're gonna wanna stay with us because we have another guest that's gonna share her fantastic miracles. Stay with us. Bless you, Carissa.
I have a miracle. I was healed of stage 4 cancer over 6 years ago without any treatment.
I have a miracle. I was healed of a stuttering problem over 24 years ago.
I have a miracle. I was healed of a ruptured disc.
People receiving miracles from God. Friend, the Bible says a believer would lay hands on the sick and they would recover. Come to our Friday night miracle service, expecting God to move for you.
Do you like receiving special gifts? I know, that's a silly question. Did you know Jesus offers an eternal and supernatural gift to each of his followers that helps us face life every day? And that gift is the Holy Ghost. Maybe you think the Holy Ghost is a fairy tale, or he just doesn't fit into your fast-paced world, or maybe you just don't care. But how can we deny the tongue of fire and the heavenly dove? Why don't you come to the Worship Center at our website and learn about this supernatural gift? You owe it to yourself.
I have 2 testimonies tonight. My first testimony is in 2010. I had a malrotation of the bowel. You prayed for me, and it God put it back in place. God did it. And the second testimony that I have, I had migraines for about 8 weeks straight. Reverend Mockimer prayed for me, and God healed me.
Welcome back. You just saw a testimony from a Friday night miracle service from Angie, and she is with us today in the studio. We want to welcome you here, Angie.
Hi, thank you.
Thank you for being with us. So we want to hear more about that testimony that you testified.
Sure. I was diagnosed with a malrotated bowel. What happened was I started to have pain in my abdominal area. It was very severe. I ended up going to the emergency room. The doctor there told me they did a CT scan, and what they found out was the malrotation. He told me I had a malrotation, but the...
What is exactly a malrotation, Angie?
A malrotation basically is where your bowel is
Shifted.
It shifted in the center. It's normally your bowel goes this direction. Mine actually went up and down. The organs, he described it as the organs that are on the right side of my body were on the left side, and the ones on the left were on the right. Wow. So, and he said they were like, they were intact is how he put
it. Is that common?
It is not. And most of the time they find this in children, and mine just did not show up until I was an adult.
So is it, it's painful then?
It's very painful. It would wake me up in the middle of the night. It was very severe. If I ate something, it hurt. When I laid down, it hurt. Nothing would subside it. Tylenol, anything like that. Mm-hmm. Nothing would take care of the pain.
And you work in a doctor's office, right?
I do. I work in a doctor's office in the hospital, and they knew that when I showed up at the emergency room that mm-hmm. I was very sick, because I just don't do that. They know I take very serious that you have to be very sick to go to the ER. Mm-hmm. So the ER doctor sent me to, he said, there's nothing we can do for you today. He said, I would like for you to see a surgeon, follow up with a surgeon. And your family doctor. So I took that to heart. I knew what was wrong with me.
What was really the solution? I mean, would they just have to open you up and rearrange everything, or?
They did not tell me. They weren't sure exactly, mm-hmm. but he said that right now there was not a threat, but he wanted me to be reassessed. My family doctor was going to, I saw him, he wanted to have the test redone that they mm-hmm. did in the hospital. And he wanted me to see a surgeon, follow up with the surgeon after the tests were completed. So I did that. But before I did that, I came to you, Reverend Millar, and received prayer. And I knew that God was going to move. God can do anything. Mm-hmm. And I
How
knew,
did you know God was going to move?
I have been a part of the ministry since I was a young child, and I have seen many miracles. And I knew that God was going to move. And when I followed up with the surgeon, and I received the results a little bit ahead of time, and I'm like, this is not the same. And the surgeon said, Angie, he's like, there's nothing wrong. Everything is back in place. And I looked at the surgeon and I said, that's the power of prayer. And I knew God did it.
God did it.
So he put everything back.
Yep, God put everything back. And I've had several tests since then, and everything is still in place. Nothing's ever moved back.
So you would have had to live in that pain yes. the rest of your life, probably.
Yes, or they probably would have had to have surgery.
And open you up and try to put it all back
correct.
In the right place.
Mm-hmm.
But God did it for them.
Yes.
And so you have medical documentation proving that your organs were originally out of place.
Yes.
And now they're back in place.
Yes, I do.
That's fantastic.
Yes.
So what causes you to hold on to those miracles that...
When I was 12 years old, I was raised at Grace Cathedral, so I saw many miracles growing up. At 12 years old, I had sprained my ankle extremely bad. I was on crutches. And I came before Reverend Angeli on a Friday night service. I walked in front of him on crutches, and he prayed for me, and I walked off carrying those crutches. That was real to me, because no one could take that away from me. God did that.
And that was an instant miracle.
It was instant. I walked away carrying those crutches, and I walked out of church in my socks. But I knew God did that.
Mm-hmm. That's amazing.
It was. It was very much amazing.
Do you have any other miracles you'd like to share with us?
Sure. I was also had migraine headaches. I started suffering with migraines in the fall. They were extreme. I had them for 8 weeks straight with no relief. Yeah. I would go to work, I would come home, they were debilitating.
Would you have to sit in a dark room, or did you have to do something?
I would dark room, I would lay down, anything, but I couldn't get the pain to go away. I went to the emergency room, they did tests, they put me on medication, but nothing would work. I went before Reverend Mockimer, one of our other associates, received prayer from him, and I started to hold on to that prayer because I knew that God was going to move. And it wasn't long after that that they went away, and I have not had a migraine since.
That's wonderful.
Yes.
And the difference between you and Carissa is that, you know, she came into the ministry, she wasn't raised in Bible truth. She didn't get to see the miracles as a child like you had the opportunity to see growing up at Grace Cathedral. So you're able to hold on to those miracles. You've seen them all your life. And what an incredible experience, you know, for God to move for you the way that He has.
Yes.
And you came in at a young age.
Yes, I came in at 6 months of age to Grace Cathedral. My parents came in, and I was raised in Sunday school. I was raised in the truth. My parents came searching for truth. And they taught me truth, and they didn't just leave it to the Sunday school teachers. They taught it at home. They lived the life before me. They prayed and fast. They received their answers from God. And I've learned to do that for myself, and they led by example. And that is truly...
That's what we're taught at Grace Cathedral.
It is, and it is. And your children are taught so well in our Sunday school class, and we have great teachers that are... They spend time with your children, and they spend time preparing each week for your children. It's not a hurry-up lesson, and they're not reading from a flyer or anything like that. They spend time and think of crafts that the children can learn and the memory verses. It's so great. I love my Sunday school experience.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. So it's fair to say that you love the Sunday school
I do. And I love watching the plays. I love being part of the Sunday school. Anything that they're doing, the children are so precious. And just to watch them.
And there's so many opportunities for the children too, because we have many programs for them.
Yes.
Music programs, junior choirs, bell choirs.
Yes.
It's just amazing what we have available at Grace Cathedral for children.
And we have so much more now than we did when I was a child. I'm a little bit jealous because they have so much more, so many more opportunities.
Yes. Well, this was a wonderful testimony.
Yes.
And, you know, God really did move in your life, and it's exciting to have you here. Well,
thank
God
you.
Bless
yes,
you, and thank you,
Angie,
for being here.
Thank you with us.
And it's just a wonderful program. And at this time, I'd like you to stay with us because we'll be right back.
It was spoken of the prophet Joel in the last days. He said he would pour it out. He's pouring it out tonight. He's pouring it out tonight. He's pouring it out.
It's time now to receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Father, I call down this great anointing upon the people. Receive ye the Holy Ghost.
If you enjoy the Ernest Angley Hour, go to our YouTube channel. Select a favorite sermon or worship song anytime, day or night. Each day can bring disappointment and discouragement, but fight back by singing and worshiping with the Lord. Don't let the enemy get an upper hand. Rejoice in the Lord. And don't forget to subscribe to be notified when new videos are loaded.
If you are enjoying today's program, let us know by sending in a donation. Your gift of love will enable others to be lifted up into the grace of God.
Don't you just love how Carissa and Angie just got their miracles? They were just pulling on God, and it was exciting.
Yes, miracles and healings are real. And if anyone needs a miracle or healing, they can call our prayer line and receive prayer and receive a miracle, or they can even write in and request for a blessed cloth or come to our Friday night service.
Yes, and just think, you know, if you have migraines, come to our Friday night service. You can receive your miracle. It doesn't matter what sickness or disease is in your body. God made you. He can heal you. So we'll see you at the Friday night miracle service, and God bless.
God bless. Bye-bye.
If this program has blessed you today, let us know on our Facebook page. You're also invited to attend any of our services. Come and witness the wonderful things of heaven for yourself. This program has been made possible by the friends and partners of Ernest Angley Ministries.